I had got a scholarship to go around the world, and I was gone for 6 months and did, you know, went to 17 different countries, went all the way around the world on a ship, and I was their scholar, one of the resident scholars on the ship, and I had to do a couple of things to earn that scholarship. And when I came back, you know, I went to CSN because I had one short semester, so I wanted to do that before I went back to the university. And Phyllis was at CSM. I met her, and she was funny because, you know, she was a real character. She pretended like she had an English accent and stuff, you know, which isn't too far wrong that we now know with her DNA she actually is English. So anyway, so we had a date planned, and we were going to go to San Francisco to North Beach and see the committee. Do you remember the committee? It was an improv theater and so on. And so we went there, and unfortunately, I had forgotten my wallet. So I had no wallet, and we decided that, you know, we'd just go get a six-pack of beer at a little mom-and-pop Chinese grocery store. And we went up to the Coin Tower.
Coin Tower.
Yeah, yeah, right. Coin Tower. And anyway, we were up there, and then after that, you know, it just seemed like we hit it off fantastic, and ever since, you know, we've always been together.
How long were you in Phyllis until you finally got married?
I would say about a year and a half, maybe, something like that.
Bigger than big, 50 years of marriage between Phyllis and Richard. Phyllis and Richard, you come here to celebrate your 50 years of marriage, matrimony, on this day, right? This is your anniversary, so happy anniversary. In front of your ohana and your friends. This is a special place. You feel the breeze that we have here. The name of the wind here is called Haupe'epe'e. And there's a story that these winds carry the tradition or mo'olelo stories that we have here. So as we go about renewing your vows today, it's basically carrying the tradition of your 50 years and with yourselves as well as your ohana and your friends and your best man. And that's what the wind is doing. We also have a rain that hopefully we don't experience right now. It's called Po'olipilipi, and it's a hard rain. It comes at an angle, but it instills wisdom in us. And I know through marriage counseling and whatnot, that you gain a lot of wisdom through being married to someone, through being with someone, through raising a family. So we have that element here. And then we have this land division that comes from the mountain all the way down to the ocean, which is called the Ahupua of Kalihi. And there's so much in here that that we have in this territory, just like there's so much in your marriage. There's so much fruit here that people come from all over to celebrate why you guys are here today. So as a person who just met you guys, I thank you guys for allowing me to be a part of what is going on here. It's amazing, truly amazing. Marriage is a commitment to life, to the best that two people can find to bring out in each other. It offers opportunities for sharing and for growth that no other human relationship can equal. Within the circle of love, marriage encompasses all of life's most important relationships, physical as well as emotional. A wife and a husband are best friends. They're lovers, they're confidants, they're teachers, they're partners, they're listeners, and in some respect, they're teammates in this game of life and what we're going through in life. There are times when one partner may become heartbroken or ailing. The other brings healing. Marriage deepens and enriches life. It happens and it makes it fuller. Marriage truly is a gift. It truly is a blessing. Marriage creates memories that are fresher and commitments that are stronger. Marriage understands and forgives the mistakes in life and is unable to avoid, and yet encourages and nurtures new life, new experiences, and new ways of expressing love through each season of life. When two people are pledged to love, cherish, and care for each other in marriage, there is a unique bond stronger than any spoken or written word. And that is love at its core, that is love at its foundation. It expresses, it encompasses everything that I believe that you guys have gone through in 50 years and that you guys will continue to go through together. Marriage is a promise, a potential that in hearts of two people will love each other, which takes a lifetime to fulfill. Aloha again to you both and to all who are present. Can I see the leis, please? So the leis are a symbol of love. It's also a symbol of things that are temporal and fragile. A lot of the leis that we have here in Hawaii is beautiful one day, and in a few days it withers. Unless you try to make it last longer, put it in a freezer. But flowers fade in time. Flowers decay. However, it kind of reminds me of life. Life is fragile. Life is, in comparison to eternity, life here on Earth is a short season. And as you guys have already, take care of one another. Hold each other's hands. Stare into each other's eyes. Understand each other's hearts. And as we in Hawaii like to say, talk story. Keep talking to each other. Build that friendship. Because it is temporary, in a sense, being together. But your love will be eternal. So can I have Phyllis, will you be able to place a sail on the tree?
Yes.
Can you do that as well? In Hawaiian, we call the kiss Honi Ika Va'a.
Honi Ika
Va'a. Va'a, sorry.
Yeah!
Yeah. So 50 years, been a while, but I believe that your love will withstand anything, no matter what happens, that your love is eternal. And this lei unites you both as well. So as you guys share in kisses, holding hands, sharing your love, so you guys are bound by this lei, as well as these vows that we have coming. So maybe you guys can face each other and I'll say these vows slowly. So Richard, will you repeat after me? I, Richard, take you, Phyllis.
I, Richard, take you, Phyllis.
To be my wife.
To be my wife.
promise to love you.
I promise to love you.
And cherish you.
And cherish you.
I will be a companion to you.
I will be a companion to you.
I promise to honor you.
I promise to honor you.
Share my strengths.
Share my strengths.
Abilities.
Abilities.
Achievements.
Achievements.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to respect you.
Care for you.
Care for you.
And be your friend.
And be your friend.
For better or for worse.
For better or for worse.
For richer or poorer.
Richer or poorer.
For sickness and
health. Sickness and health.
For as long as you both shall live.
For as long as you both shall live.
Okay, if I can get through this.
We can take more than you. I think you're richer.
I think you're richer. To be my husband.
I promise to love you and cherish you.
I promise to love you and cherish you.
I will be a companion to you.
I will be a companion to you.
I promise to honor you.
I promise to honor you.
Share my strength.
Share my strength.
Abilities.
Abilities.
And achievements.
And achievements.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
I promise to respect you.
I promise to respect you.
Care for you.
Care for you.
Be your friend.
To be your friend.
For better or worse.
For better or worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
For sickness and health.
For sickness and health.
For as long as you both shall
live. For as long as you both shall live.
See the ring, please. These rings here, a bracelet and a ring, are symbols of longevity. And they're precious, and there's two symbols that I can be reminded of. First of all, the ring is made out of, and the bracelet is made out of precious metal. And in order for the metal to become precious, it has to go through the fire. It has to go through the fire for the impurities to rise up out of it. And then after it gets tested, it goes through trials, it's looked at as pure and as precious. Also, the ring symbolizes a circle, which means that your love is eternal. And no matter what happens here on earth, your love will endure for one another. Your love is forever. I give you this bracelet.
I give you this bracelet.
As a sign of my love.
There we go.
Alright. I give you this bracelet.
I give you this bracelet.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
I give myself to you.
I give myself to you.
To be your husband.
To be your husband.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
I am honored.
I am honored.
To continue to be your husband.
To continue to be your husband.
You are the best person.
You are the best person.
I have ever known.
I have ever known.
All that I have.
All that I have.
And all that I have said.
All that I have said.
I seal with this bracelet.
I seal with this bracelet.
Repeat after me. Richard, I give you this ring.
Richard, I give you this ring.
As a sign of my love.
As a sign of my love.
I give myself to you.
I give myself to you.
To be your wife.
To be your wife.
Now and forever.
Now and forever.
I'm
honored.
To continue to be your wife.
Continue to be your wife.
You're the best person
I've ever known.
All that I have.
All that I have.
And all that I have said.
All that I've said.
I seal with this ring.
I seal with this ring.
We have all come to witness this true love. And on this special day, therefore those who are present have shared in this renewal of your wedding vows to celebrate your 50th wedding anniversary. And if you could, I would like you to face that way and face your family and friends. And I'm going to share something that my coworker came up with. Oke aloha kamenui. Oke kumu no kako. Hui ana mai. O kamanao o ao. Ke ao ana o ke ka ko ao. Ke aloha ke kukui no laila e lama lama. E kukui a pio ole me a mamo e ho'omano I ka na'ao. Ae holomua me ke aloha. I've heard some of the stories, I've heard the testimony of what happened 50 years and what's going on now, and this poem basically shares that love is number one. Love is the foundation, and love is what will keep you going through the darkest times, through the roughest times. There's also says that marriage is the epitome of love, and that marriage brings light into this world and light into the lives. Just as every day we have morning and night, there's always a new day. No matter what happens in life, Richard and Phyllis and Ohana and friends, I want to encourage you all to love one another. Aloha ke kahi I ke kahi. Love is first. Love one another. And if you guys wouldn't mind, I just want to close with another benediction. If you guys won't mind closing your eyes. The Lord bless you, the Lord keep you, the Lord make His face shine upon you and give you peace. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Family and friends, it is my privilege and my honor and my joy to pronounce again 50 years later, Mr. and Mrs. Richard and Phyllis Vohs.
I can my heart. Thank you for coming, you guys.
From left to right, Brian Guerrero and Phyllis Vohs. Brian is considered by Dick and Phyllis to be their Hawaiian son. Miss Martha Stapleton, and on the right, Janet Klassen, a friend and neighbor of the Vohs. From left to right, Kaiana Guerrero, she's the daughter of Francis II Guerrero and Kim Guerrero. Kim Guerrero, spouse of Francis II Guerrero. Nani Guerrero, the mother of Brian and Francis II. And Momi, founder and director of Kaiki Oka'aina Learning Center. Left to right, Jim Ron Byberg, Dick and Phyllis's best man 50 years ago and classmate from Menlo Atherton. Next is Eric Vohs, Dick and Phyllis's oldest son, and one of the top business bankers in America from Indianapolis, Indiana. And lastly on the right, Dick Vohs. Two granddaughters of Dick and Phyllis Vohs, and their parents, Eric and Nicole Vohs. Jordan on the left is a recent high school graduate cum laude and freshman at Indiana University. And to the right, her sister, Sydney Vohs, is a high school freshman and competitive swimmer. Left to right is Ryan Vohs, Dick and Phyllis's youngest son, and he's business owner, Sisters, Oregon. Next to him is his wife, Jamie Vohs. She is the executive assistant, Black Butte Fire Chief. And lastly on the right is Deb Glander, longtime neighbor and friend of Dick and Phyllis. Left to right, Sierra Morales' boyfriend. Next to him is Sierra Morales, that's Chef Hector's oldest daughter. Then Rainey Morales, that's Chef Hector's spouse, Sierra's mom. And then there's Narida Morales, Chef Hector's mother. And Hector Morales Sr., that's Chef Hector's dad. The 50th anniversary feast was prepared by Hector Morales, longtime friend of Dick and Phyllis. He's a world-class chef and was chef to the King of Norway. Executive Chef, Turtle Bay Resort for 18 years. James Beard Award Honoree. Executive Chef, Polynesian Cultural Center. On the far left in the photo, Rich Wendlin, a longtime friend of Dick's, Vohs from Berkeley in 1970. He lives in Philomath, Oregon, off the grid on a mountaintop. Then to the right, Garrett Vohs, son of Ryan and Jamie Vohs, grandson of Dick and Phyllis. He's a high school sophomore, incredible athlete. Ryan Vohs, Dick and Phyllis's youngest son and business owner of Sisters, Oregon. Then Eric Vohs, Dick and Phyllis's oldest son and one of the top business bankers in America, as previously mentioned. And on the far right, Jordan Vohs, daughter of Eric and Nicole Vohs, and she's the granddaughter of Dick and Phyllis Vohs. Jim Ron Byberg and his wife Sue. Jim was best man 50 years ago for Dick and Phyllis Vohs in 1968, and again today, 50 years later, June 22nd, 2018.
Wake up where the clouds are far behind.